Raya Radha Madhava Kanyari Hari Radha Jaya Radha Madhava Kanyari Hari Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama Rama Hare 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 Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Jaya Prabhupada, 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 Srila Prabhupada. Prabhupada, 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 Jaya Prabhupada. Nitai Gaur Haribo, 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 Gaur Haribo, Haribo,
Jai Om Vishnupad Paramahamsa Paramahamsa Kachara Stokata Sajjan Divine Swami Srila Prabhupada Kija. Iskcon founder Acharya Srila Prabhupada Kija. BBT founder Srila Prabhupada Kija. Nam Acharya Srila Haridas Thakur Kija. Pram Sigaho Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda. Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shivazadi Gaura Bhaktivinoda Kija. Shri Shri Radha Krishna Gopa Gopinath Shyamakund Radhakund Giri Govardhana Kija. Shri Vrindavan Dham Kija. Mayapur Navadvip Dham Kija. Ganga Maya Kija, Jamuna Maya Kija, Tulsi Devi Kija, Bhakti Devi Kija, most beautiful lordships, Sri Sri Radha Landanishwara Kija, Jagannath Baladev Subhaja Maharani Kija, Giriraj Maharaj Kija, Sri Sri Gornitai K, Harinam Sankirtan Kija, Sankirtan Yagya Kija, Abrihamidanga Transcendental Book Distribution Kija, Nitai Gaura Premanandi. All glories to the assembled devotees. All glories to the assembled devotees. All glories to the assembled devotees. All glories to the lotus feet of Sri Guru and Sri Gauranga. All glories to Sri Hare Krishna. So welcome everyone. Thank you very much for attending Srimad Bhagavatam class. Before I begin, I would first like to seek blessings, especially from His Grace Parivida Prabhu, that you see see fit to bestow your mercy upon me so that I can speak something bona fide and relevant this morning. Hare Krishna. Before we begin, please, we can recite the invocation. We'll be starting a new chapter this morning from the 10th canto of the Srimad Bhagavatam, starting with chapter 85. We are almost finished the 10th canto of the Bhagavatam. Anyone remembers how many chapters there are? Dun dun. 77? 87? Getting close. There are 90 chapters, and we are at 85, so just 5 more chapters of the 10th canto. So, final opportunities to relish the direct and clear pastimes of Lord Krishna. Okay, so please repeat. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. So chapter 85, the 10th canto, we'll read the chapter summary and then texts 1, 2, and we will repeat text 3 together. So the chapter is entitled, Lord Krishna Instructs Vasudev and Retrieves Devaki's Sons. This chapter relates how Lord Krishna imparted divine knowledge to his father, and, along with Lord Balaram, retrieved his mother's dead sons. Having heard the visiting sages glorify Krishna, Vasudev ceased to regard him and Balaram as his sons and began praising their omnipotence, omnipresence, and omniscience as the supreme personality of Godhead. After glorifying his sons, Vasudev fell at Lord Krishna's lotus feet and begged him to drive away the conception that the Lord was his son. Instead, Lord Krishna restored that conception by instructing Vasudev in the science of Godhead. And upon hearing these instructions, Vasudev became peaceful and free of doubt. Then Mother Devaki praised Krishna and Balaram, reminding them how they had retrieved the dead sons of their spiritual master. She said, "Please fulfill my desire in the same way. Please bring back my sons who were killed by Kamsa, so I may see them once again." Entreated in this way by their mother, the two lords went to the subterranean planet of Sutala, where they approached Bali Maharaj. King Bali greeted them respectfully, offering them seats of honor, worshipping them, and reciting prayers. Krishna and Balaram then requested Bali to return Devaki's dead sons. The lords received the boys from Bali and returned them to Devaki, who felt such a surge of affection for them that milk began spontaneously flowing from her breasts. Overjoyed, Devaki fed the children her breast milk, and by drinking the remnants of milk once drunk by Lord Krishna himself, they regained their original forms as demigods and went back to heaven. So we have an exciting chapter ahead. So text number 1. Shibananayuvacha Ataika Dadmajao Prap sorry. Ataika Dadmajao Paptao Krita Pada Bivandanao Vasudevo Binandyaha Pritya Sankarshanachuta. Sri Badarayani said, One day the two sons of Vasudev, Sankarshan and Achyuta, came to pay him respects, bowing down at his feet. Vasudev greeted them with great affection and spoke to them. So I'll also read this one on my own, and text three we'll repeat together.
Muninam savacha shrutva putrayor dama suchakam tadvirya jata vishramba paribasyabhya basashata.
Having heard the great sage's words concerning the power of his two sons, and having seen their valorous deeds, Vasudev became convinced of their divinity. Thus, addressing them by name, he spoke to them as follows. So please repeat.
Krishna Krishna Mahayogin Sankarshan Sanatana Janeva Masya Yatsakshat Pradhan Purushau Parau Krishna Krishna Mahayogin Sankarshana Sanatana Janeva Masya Yat Sakshat Pradana Purushau Parau Krishna Krishna Mahayogin Sankarshan Sanatana Janeva Masya Yat Sakshat Pradana Purushau Parau
word for word. Krishna Krishna, O Krishna Krishna, Mahayogin, O greatest yogi, Sankarshan, O Balaram, Sanatana, eternal, Jane, I know, Vam, you too, Asya, of this universe, yet,
which sakshat directly pradana, the creative principle of nature, purushau, and the creating personality of Godhead, parau, supreme. Translation and purport by the disciples of His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Vasudev said, O Krishna, Krishna, best of yogis, O eternal Sankarshan, I know that you too are personally the source of universal creation and the ingredients of creation as well. Purport. As taught in the Sankhya doctrine of Lord Kapila Dev, Pradhan is the creative energy of the Purusha, the Supreme Person. Thus, of these two principles, the Pradhan is the predominated energy, female, incapable of independent action, while the Purusha is the absolutely independent, primeval creator and enjoyer. Neither Krishna nor his brother Balaram belong to the category of subordinate energy. Rather, both of them together are the original Purusha, who is always joined by his manifold potencies of pleasure, knowledge, and creative emanation. Om Ajnanatimirandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshuram Militangena Tasmai Shri Guruve Namaha Shri Chaitanya Manobishtam Stapitam Gena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamayam Dadati Swapadantikam Vandeham Shri Gurun Shri Yuta Parakamalam Shri Gurun Vaishnavamscha Shri Rupam Sagrajatam Sahagana Raghunathanvitam Tam Sajivam Sarvetam Savadutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Shri Radha Krishna Padan Sahagana Lalita Shri Vishakan Vitamscha He Krishna Karuna Sindhu Dina Bandhu Jagatpate Gopisha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namostute Tapta Kanchana Gaurange Radhe Vrindavanishwari Rishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Vancha Kalpa Tarubhyascha Kripa Sindhubhyevacha Patidanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namaha Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu. This is the reference here. So when the Lord glances over the Mahatattva, then the three gunas are agitated. So by his glance over the Mahatattva, the three gunas are Tamagun, Rajagun, and Sattvagun. I mean, I'm sure everyone here has become liberated from the three gunas, so we forget easily what they are. Unfortunately, I'm submerged in them. And she begins to give birth in so many varieties of the 24 elements. So here we see also the pronoun she, referring to Prakriti as feminine. Okay, so we're starting to get the distinction Purusha and Prakriti. So Prakriti, the material elements, is the feminine nature. And when the Supreme Personality of Godhead glances over this Mahatattva, then the three gunas become agitated, and then she begins to give birth to so many varieties of the 24 elements. We have already discussed the 24 elements, so we're not going to get into that one because we've already discussed it, okay? The ingredients are there. That is Prakriti. And pradhan means when they are not manifested. And prakriti means when they are manifested. Okay, so, and prakriti, pradhan, and above them there is purusha. So here he's saying that pradhan means that the elements have not become manifested. So that's the previous statement. It's like the ether, you know, so it's just all merged. But the prakriti is once it becomes, the elements become clearly manifested, then that is prakriti. Okay? Is that okay? Makes sense so far? And prakriti, pradhan, and above them, there is the purusha. That purusha is Bhagawan. And Bhagawan. Chaista yata sa Bhagawan. Where from the prakriti begins to manifest, that is with the touch of Bhagawan. How touch? Sa aikshata. By simply glancing over, the prakriti becomes pregnant. The ingredients are there. That is prakriti. And pradhan means when they are not manifest. And prakriti means when they are manifest. Now, we cannot understand how one can make his wife pregnant simply by glancing. So this is the Lord's capacity, that simply by his glance, he impregnates the Mahatattva, which is also called known as the pradhan. And by that glance, the three modes become agitated and starts to give birth to the 24 elements. Okay? Therefore, he is called the Almighty. We have got experience. If we want to make pregnant wife, then we have to use certain sense. That particular sense can make pregnancy. But the Supreme Personality of Godhead, being all-powerful, he can do anything from anywhere, from any sense. That is Almighty. We speak of Almighty. God is Almighty. But we do not understand what is Almighty. This is Almighty, the Almighty Lord. Simply by glancing over prakriti, he makes the prakriti pregnant, and the prakriti produces so many varieties of life. Of course, Prabhupada seems here to be continually referring to prakriti when it seems that he's, after what he's just said about prakriti and pradhan, because he's saying he's glancing over prakriti and then gets prakriti to create so many varieties. But it seems that he should be saying pradhan, and then prakriti is created as varieties. So prakriti cannot give birth to the varieties. That is the wrong theory. The real variety begins when the prakriti is in touch with the purusha. That is our experience also. How we can say that prakriti can give birth, or woman can give birth to a child or many children without being in touch with man. Where is our experience? There is no such thing. Still, is there any experience of that? Just because sometimes, you know, people might say, yeah, but that's old news. I remember once I said in a talk that we can't see the soul because it's 1/10,000th the tip of a hair. And one scientist said, but now we have atomic microscopes. So we should be able to see the soul because we can see something that's 1/10,000th the size of a hair. And I was a little bit stumped because and I said, okay, so if you can bring that microscope around, we can have a look and see if we can find the soul. But obviously the adage of being 1/10,000th the tip of a hair may not exactly be the measurement of the soul. It's an understanding that the soul is so tiny that you can't see it. And it's, you know, even the tip of a hair sometimes is hard to see. If you divided the tip of a hair by 100, it'd be like, forget it. You know, so divide it by another 100, that's, you know, that's impossible. So just wondering, is there any situation where a woman has... Jesus. Somehow I knew someone was going to say that. Huh? But still there has to be contact with man's bits and pieces. Something came from somewhere else outside. Huh? Only Jesus is the only way, right? So, They clone animals. Does it actually come just for they put it in a petri dish? Yeah, definitely they use cells and genetic DNA and genetic cloning. But there's still, I guess, Prabhupada's statement would be life comes from life. So they still have to take it from something that's living that has manifest in that way. Of course, there's also, I know there's a place in the Bhagavatam, I can't remember which pastime, where Prabhupada says, so here's evidence also of cloning. There's some pastime, isn't it, where there's... Was it the... I can't remember. Huh? Vena, yes, like that. Yeah, something. Anyway, there's different pastimes like that. And then... Yeah, so like that. Yeah. So that's, again, life comes from life. But yeah, it seems that they continue to live. Earthworms just go on living if you cut them in half, right? Then there's two. Yeah, it's like, so like that. I remember, actually, I think, is it Mahavishnu Maharaj who asked Srila Prabhupada about that? He tells that story. He said he thought he had that amazing thing, and he was, I think they were in Russell Square, right, or something, and he rushed up to Prabhupada. What happens when an earthworm is cut in half? And then they both seem to live. It was just one soul, and then Prabhupada, he just said, another soul enters. And he just walked. Something really simple, Prabhupada just said. So yeah, like that. But in general, I guess, apart from Mother Mary, we can understand that that in general, for a child to be born, there has to be some contact with the man. So Srila Prabhupada is stating here, and then he gives some further explanation. He says, there is no such thing. Therefore, we should not take Prakriti as everything. We must find out the Purusha. Therefore, the Purusha who gives birth to these material varieties, that is who? Who is the Purusha who gives birth to all the varieties? No. Now that you know it's not any of those, then we should be narrowing it down. So, who becomes the glance of Lord Vishnu? Lord Shiva, yes. So, Lord Shiva. That is Lord Shiva. And the Prakriti which gives birth to these varieties, that is Durga. So, that is Lord Shiva and Durga Devi. Therefore, the original Prakriti and Purusha are represented by Shiva Linga and Devi Pata. Those who are worshippers of Shiva Linga, they know the Devi Pata. And the Shiva Linga, they are worshipped. The original father, Krishna, says, Aham Bija Pradapita. I am the seed giving father. Sarva Yonishu. Kunteya Sambhavanti Murtayo Yaha. There are varieties and forms of life. How are they begotten? Krishna says, Aham Bija Pradapita. I am the seed giving father. Lord Shiva. He is a seed-giving father. So when Krishna comes in touch with Prakriti for giving birth and these varieties of forms of life, that is Shiva, that is Shiva. Shiva is not different from Krishna, but still Shiva is not Krishna. This is called inconceivable oneness and difference. Inconceivable one and different. The example is given just like milk and dahi. Dahi is not different from milk. It is milk. It is milk, everyone knows, but it is not milk at the same time. You cannot get the benefit of milk by drinking dahi or yogurt. Milk is used for different purpose, and dahi is different purpose. When you take too much milk, you get dysentery. And if you go to the physician, he gives you some medicine to take with yogurt. So dahi or yogurt is not different from milk, but it is not milk. Similarly, all these demigods, especially Lord Shiva, Lord Brahma, they are the original chief demigods from Vishnu. So This is Srila Prabhupada's just one. Of course, there are many places where this is explained. Statement about Pradhan and Prakriti and the glance of Mahavishnu over the Mahatattva or Pradhan, which then infatuates the three modes of material nature, and they produce all the varieties of living entities and all the varieties of material elements. And then we also understand that what happens once that, so Mahavishnu glances over the Mahatattva, and this is manifest, then what happens? How does everything become manifest? Because the Lord enters into that, he expands himself again as Garbhadakshaya Vishnu and enters into the Mahatattva, and from his navel sprouts Lord the lotus, and on the lotus is sitting Lord Brahma, and Lord Brahma becomes the engineer or the first original person in the Mahatattva, and from him he begins to formulate the elements, and he is also known as the creator. So in this situation we can understand there are quite a number of creators. I guess not just the Supreme Lord. He is the original cause of all causes, Sarvakarana Karanam. But from his glance, Lord Shiva becomes a creator because he's doing the service of impregnating Prakriti. And then the Lord enters in again and he gives birth to Lord Brahma. And Lord Brahma then becomes another secondary creator like that. So I don't know if this made any sense at all. Yes, Mother, please help me out here. Oh, question, okay. Yes, that's... that Lord Shiva is... Here, you can just hold on to that. Lord Shiva is the personification of Mahavishnu's glance. That's my understanding, yes.
But then, the idea is that... Lord Vishnu doesn't want to come directly in contact with Prakriti, mm-hmm. because he's always aloof, mm-hmm. right?
Yeah.
But then after after everything is manifested, then he enters into it as Garbhadakshaya Vishnu. So then ultimately he's coming kind of in contact with it.
Yeah, I hadn't heard that the Lord doesn't want to, like, oh, I got to stay away from my separated energy. I had never heard it kind of like he didn't want to, just that he never becomes touched by it. Even if he enters into it, he's still untouched. Even he comes and manifests in, you know, the Lord Ram, Lord Krishna, Varaha, he's still untouched.
Mm, okay, I had heard it like that before.
Okay, yeah, I hadn't heard that it's not that he doesn't want to kind of come in touch with it, but he's never touched by it.
Yeah.
He's never affected by it. Otherwise, that's a different philosophy. That's the Mayavad philosophy, believes that the Lord is also in Maya.
Mm-hmm.
So, but he's not affected by it. It's just that he doesn't need to get off his, you know, Shesha Nag bed and disturb Lakshmi Devi and go and deal with the material energy. He just, you know, he looks and... and by his glance, then his glance is potent, like the seminal of a man would be potent. So the egg is there, but until the egg, you know, interacts with the potent, it doesn't become, you know, fully manifest. No child is there. So in the same way, the Lord's glance is completely potent, like Prabhupada would say. We understand that you have to use certain senses to procreate, but the Lord can procreate with just by looking. So like that. Which we might understand is what happened in the case of Mother Mary, somehow or another like that. Because a similar type of thing is described for the manifestation of for Devaki and like that. Divinity. Does that make any sense? Yeah, kind of thing. Anyone else? Any comments, questions, corrections, chastisements? Yes. Narnas. The Atma.
Yes. Where is the Atma originally? Is it in Mahatattva, that means in Brahman, or is it in I don't know, in Vishnu, in his glands, where is the original position?
It's a good question, because one might think that it should be in the glands, if you're using the same comparison. But it's described, as we just read here, that inside of the Mahatattva, it is the resting place of all the material elements, as well as all the living entities. So the Paraprakriti and the Aparaprakriti are all resting inside of the Mahatattva. So everything, all the living entities who are in the material world, they're merged back into the Mahatattva at the dissolution of the material world, and they're resting there waiting for that glance and the material energy to be created, and then they're repopulated into the material energy. That's my understanding. So the potency of the living entities is all there inside of the, because it's also, the Mahatattva is also compared to the universal egg, right? Of course, some, you know, atheistic thinkers, you know, consider that ridiculous, you know, but the principle is quite deep and profound. You know, I mean, when the persons, I guess the British, when they came to India and they were saying, oh, look how barbaric this is, this whole idea, they're worshipping this Shiva Linga and all these things, it's all sexual and this God is, and you know, they just thought the whole thing was barbaric, but they just didn't have a clue how they were understanding the actual manifestation of the world on the macro and the micro levels, that, you know, so it's quite advanced. But in that sense, so the potency is there in the Mahatattva, the universal egg, but until Krishna's glance is there, nothing can happen until that contact. Then it becomes, I guess you could say, fertilized and manifests. Does that make sense?
It's like a trigger.
Like a trigger.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay. That's the example you want to use, yeah. Pull the trigger, and whatever happens after that. Big Bang. Yeah, it's the trigger for the Big Bang, yeah. And then it is kind of like that. Okay? Yes, Prabhu.
When the time starts. What is the time in this creation?
When does the time start? You mean time for breakfast? You're trying to get me to hurry up and finish? When is the time? Where is Kala? Yeah, so actually, in that same lecture, Srila Prabhupada refers to, let's see, he refers to Lord Shiva. He says that he has another name, and he says that that name is, oh, yeah, I'm not going to find it now, Kala something or other. Another name for Lord Shiva is Kala. So, yeah, I'm not going to be able to find it right now. So basically, he explains that Lord Shiva is in charge of destruction. Of course, it's interesting because we usually understand that tamagun means he destroys everything. He does his dance of devastation, and everything gets wrapped up. And but he's also the source of creation in one sense. So, but Srila Prabhupada says that he has this other name of Kala. I can't find it now, but let's see. And because everything, he is the end of everything. Let's see if I can find it. But yeah, here it is. He says, Kala Bhairava. Bhairava. Kala Bhairava. And he is the master of annihilation. When this whole material world will be required to be destroyed, that will be done by Lord Shiva. So Lord Shiva therefore says something. So Kala, the time factor, is the supreme personality of Godhead, and it is above the 24 ingredients of the material elements. It is between the spiritual element and the material element. It's a via medium, the Kala. This is the description of Kala. So time is, in one sense, I guess, always present, or it says in the spiritual world it's conspicuous by its absence, but the clock starts ticking once Shiva enters, then, you know, it's like that. That's the point at which you start counting. Sort of like when someone becomes pregnant, that's the point at which you start counting. So in that sense, the countdown begins. It's a trigger. Okay, is that all right? Om Agnanati Manandasya. Okay, last question.
In the summary, there was a sentence where Devaki was asking Krishna, can you bring back my sons?
Yes.
Same as you did for your spiritual master.
Yes.
Can you please remind us about that spiritual master and who his son was?
Yeah, that's great. Perfect question. And you all can come back tomorrow for the answer to that one. Because someone else will be speaking to that. Tomorrow, Parivitapuru will be giving class, so he may get to that point. Depends on how the verses flow. But it's like what they call in the movie industry a cliffhanger. So you have expertly prepared us so that everyone online and everyone can buy the book. you can buy the book. We got a whole set of them right up there. 108 pounds, but that'll just get you the first 9 cantos. So 200 pounds will get you the whole 10. So like that. Okay. So tune in tomorrow. Jai Grantharaj Srimad Bhagavatam Ki Jai Anantakoti Vaishnava Vrinda Ki Jai Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Ki Jai. Okay. So for the pleasure of the Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai, His Grace Parivita Prabhu Ki Jai. So, for the pleasure of their lordships, Srila Prabhupada and the assembled Vaishnavas, we have some Sankirtan scores from yesterday. Let's see, Closet Krishna score, not here on paper, so I have to find it on. Okay, so. Okay, so and Radha's boot or in Closet Krishna, we distributed one small book, two medium books for 134.35 Lakshmi points. And in Radha's boutique, we distributed three books for 173 Lakshmi points. And in Govinda's restaurant, we distributed prasadam to at least 302 customers for a total of 2,468 Lakshmi points. Yesterday on book distribution, as a build-up for the book distribution sprint for Rath Yatra, we had 5 scores reported, starting with Prananath Prabhu, collected 18 Lakshmi, distributed 11 medium books for 5.5 book points. Bhaktin Rosalina, 17 Lakshmi points, 16 medium, 8 book points. Prabhupada Priya Mataji, 28 Lakshmi points, 25 small, 13 medium, for 12.75 book points. Bhakta Aryan, 58 Lakshmi points, 17 medium books, 8 Maha big books for 24.5 book points. And Bhakta Vayu Prabhu, 158 Lakshmi points, 52 medium books, 23 Maha big books for 72 book points. That was 2 days, was it? Yeah, okay, amazing. That was just standing out front here while they were doing kirtan, huh? Okay, just see. So total of 5 scores, 279 Lakshmi points, 25 small, 109 medium, 31 Maha big for 122.75 book points. Srila Prabhupada Chancellor Book Distribution Key. So we are having a sprint. It's our monthly opportunity for everyone to get involved. One of our goals is to have at least 30 names on the score sheet. So that way we're trying to get everyone involved in distributing Srila Prabhupada's books. So that means all you have to do is sponsor or distribute one book. Can everyone distribute one book in 4 days? One Lakshmi, one Lakshmi you can find on the street outside somewhere. One little pound, probably not even that, 78 pence or something. You can sponsor a medium book and get your name on the score sheet. So that's one of our goals, to make sure that everyone in the community is becoming active in distributing Srila Prabhupada's books. So please, if everyone can get their name on the score sheet, starting today, if we do that, if everyone in the room today gets their name on the score sheet, then that's already 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. We're already half the way there. So like that, okay? So if everyone can please participate. Also, we'll say our prayer to their lordships, but we also need volunteers to help serve the breakfast prasadam this morning on the men's side and on the ladies' side. Any volunteers? Okay. And volunteers to help clean up the temple room after breakfast. One, anyone else who can help with that service? Glorious service. Okay. All right. Thank you. And this morning, breakfast has been sponsored, and also there will be special treat which we'll wait and surprise everyone with, which has also been sponsored, and it's been sponsored as an offering to their lordship, Shishi Radhalanda Nishwar, but on this auspicious and special occasion of the birthday of Rasvilas Prabhu. Hariva! So we'd just like to say congratulations and thank you for coming and spending your birthday here with us and sponsoring the feast. Rasvilas Prabhu has been doing much service here for many years in the Pujari department, and now Brahman initiated and cooking, I think, is it Tuesday? Every Tuesday? Every Tuesday. And we had our first meeting many years ago. I don't even remember how long ago it was. He drove me to Manchester for a sort of debate on television. And actually, that was where this famous atheist, what's his name? Richard Dawkins, he was at that debate. So we were, we had some interaction and conversation there. So it was a long journey, and I think I was half asleep most of the time. But he was very excellent and very wonderful devotee and doing so much service. And so nice to have you with us this morning. Rasvilasru, Hare Krishna. So we'll offer our prayer to their lordships. Dear Shishi Radhalanda Nishwar, Jagannath Baladev and Subhadra, Shishi Gornitai, and Giri Govardhan, we offer our most respectful obeisances unto you. With a mood of deep gratitude and appreciation, we request your causeless mercy upon us. For your pleasure, if you so desire, we wish to erect a holy place of your transcendental pastimes that will attract unlimited souls to your service and fulfill the vision of your pure devotee Srila Prabhupada for London. Please enable us to cooperate together in order to satisfy you in this way. We, your surrendered servants, humbly beg. New temple for the lordships, ki jai. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Okay, so if everyone could please help to bring the prasadam up from downstairs, then we can serve it out and get on with the day's activities. Hare Krishna.
Ouch! I got another foot. It's okay.